Hello guys, welcome back once again to the channel Get It Quickly, and welcome back to the ongoing series on Notepad++. So in this series, we are actually learning all the features what we have in our Notepad++, a free text editor. So in the last video, we actually learned how we can find any of the words we have in our text file and what features we have in our find window, right? In this video, we are gonna learn how we can replace a word by finding that word. So again, we are gonna hit Control F either, or we can also hit Control H directly to open up the same window with the different tab, which is the replace tab, right? So in the replace tab, basically we do have the exact same features that we have in the find tab. Here we had count, find all in current document, find all in all open documents. Now in the replace tab, we have replace, replace all in all open documents. So what we can do here now is basically we are going to replace the word flag with something else. For example, I'm going to type indicator, right? And then I'm going to replace this flag word with the word indicator. But first of all, I'm going to see like which instance of the flag is going to be replaced. For example, if I'm going to replace this guy, I need to point out this instance. So I'm going to go find, and then here I am. And then I'm going to replace this one, right? You can see like it actually replaced the word flag with the word indicator. But the thing is like, if I'm gonna just replace one instance of this guy, because this is all programming, this will basically create a syntax error. Like this word flag is not declared, and this declared indicator word is not even used anywhere. So if I am gonna replace a word or a variable in any of the coding, then I have to basically replace all of them. Right? So a lot of times what happens, like, okay, I don't like this name and I really want to change wherever this variable I have already used in my coding, right? And this is the great place to do this, right? If I'm gonna do replace all, in just one click it will replace every instance of flag, right? Let's see. See, now if you try to find next, see, there's no flag because it actually replaced with all the word indicator. There is this button which means like you can just toggle whatever you have just done, or of course you can change whatever the names you want it to be. So what I can do, like I can do it again with some kind of other thing, or maybe whatever I had before, right? So I just do it and then I will do replace all and it will come up again, right? So this is what we can basically do. And here you can see I did have match whole word only checked. That's why just 7 occurrences of that word were replaced, right? So let's try one more time. Like, okay, I'm still want to do the same thing, like replacing flag with indicator. And this time I'm gonna uncheck this guy. And now I'm gonna do it replace all. And you can see like this guy indicator also replaced the word flag in the word flags, right? You can also use this function because still in the other file, if you remember, we already typed the word flag there and then we tried to find out that word there, you know, in the previous video. Now we are playing with the replacing thing. If I am gonna do this guy replace all in all documents, it will actually replace the word flag in the other file as well, right? So let's do it. Are you sure you want to replace all occurrence in all open documents? Yes, of course, that's what I want, right? And then replace in opened files, one occurrence was replaced, right? So just go back here and see, it actually replaced the word flag with the word indicator. Okay, so isn't it cool? So this is all for this video. So guys, please subscribe the channel because we are gonna continue this journey together and learn all that features. Basically, this is the investment we are doing for ourselves. Once we learn all that features, tips and tricks, we can definitely apply in our daily work, and then we can save tons of minutes out there. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for the next videos and tell me if you have any suggestions, any questions or comments in the comments section. And if you think I am missing anything, just let me know and I will definitely cover that thing, and that's how we can learn all together. Thanks for watching.